today we are going to solve a line graph question, and I've given a diagrammatic representation here. So this is the question we are going to solve today, and the question is about, let me explain you the details of the question, and let's move to the questions. So this line graph represents an XYZ bistro restaurant. In this restaurant, some of its customers post reviews about the restaurant on social media. So they are posting the reviews about this restaurant in social media, and the customers post only two types of reviews, which is positive and negative review. Okay, this line graph suggests that the restaurant is asked to provide a review. So the customers are providing the reviews, with the reviews consist of positive and negative reviews. So this line graph represents the positive and negative reviews and total number of reviews. So this y-axis, which is the total number of persons, and this x-axis is the monthly reviews, which represents those monthly reviews, and the dotted line here have represented the total review. So total review, which is this positive plus negative review, is the total review as they are given in the question, and this solid line is the positive review. They have not given the negative review, so you have to find the negative review first from the given line graph, then you have to move to the questions to solve it. So first let me tell you how to find the negative review from the line graph. It is very simple method. When you know the total review and positive review, you just have to add it an extra number to get the negative review. So here, for the month of January, they have given 120, and I've represented the values here because the diagram is not clear. So here the total review values are 120, 160, 110, 130, 140, 150 and 180 from January to July month. So only two values are given in the line graph, which is the total review value and the positive review. These two lines are only given in this line graph. So the positive review values are 70, 80, 60, 50, 70, 60, 80. So you have to add on to this 70, you will get 120 as a total. The adding value will be the negative review. So finding for the negative review to get 120, 70 plus 50 is 120, 80 plus 80 is 160. So finding negative review values are very easy when you have the total review value and positive review value. So moving to the question. First question is, how to solve this question? How many months did the number of positive reviews? For January, we are solving February, March, April, May, June and July. I've done for the February. 50 is less value than the 58. So it is decreasing than the previous month value. So we will take February as an option. Another thing, 50 we are having in the previous month in February. So March has 54.5. It is increasing, so leave this value. Next, we are moving to April. So the previous month value is 54.5. It must be greater than 54.5 in the next value, but it is less than. So the decrease value is coming here than the previous month value. So we are taking April also, which is 38.4%. Now the next value should be less than 38.4%. Or maybe greater than 38.4%. We should take the lesser value here as an option. So it must be less than 38.4. For May it is 50%, which is greater than the previous month. So we are not taking the May. And we are going to compare the May and June. So we are having 50% in the May. 50% in the May. So we have to get the decreased value in the next month. It must be decreasing than the 50. So June we are having 40%. So we are taking June as the option. Here next, next value is July. Next month value must be decreasing than the 40. But here it is increasing 44.4. So we are not taking into account. So these three, February, April and June, are having a decreased value when compared to the previous month value. So these three are the answers. So we are giving the option as February, June and April. The answer option will be like 3 month or 2 month or 4 month they will be asking. So you have to click as a three option as the answer, and this way the question will be asked to find. You just don't go deeper into the question, and don't distract from the question. You just apply what they're asking in the question, which is how many months did the number of positive reviews as the percentage of the total number of reviews. So you just find the total number of reviews with the positive reviews and compare it with the previous month values, so you will get the answer. And this is about the first question. Let's move to the second question. Second question is, all these questions I'm solving is from the TCY app, which is very good for taking mock test for MAT and CAT exams. So I'm solving the question from this TCY online app. Try it for mock exams, it will be very useful. So let's move to the second question. Here they're asking, number of positive review exceeds the number of negative review by 25%. So the question is, they're asking from January to July, the number of positive review exceeds the number of negative review by 25%. So this question actually mentions a formula from the percentage, which is A is what percent more than B. So here it is given as the number of positive review exceeds the number of negative reviews by 25%. So we are using this formula here, which is A minus B by B into 100. This is the formula we are using for this question. And once again, yeah, this is the formula we are using here. This formula is A is what percent more than B. In this type of question, when number of positive review exceeds the number of negative reviews, or the percentage of A increases than B, if these type of questions are asked, then you have to use A minus B by B into 100. This is a percentage formula which is used here. So let's move to the solution part now. So what they're asking, number of negative review exceeds the number, how many months the number of positive review exceeds the number of negative review. So these are the positive reviews and these are the negative reviews, and they're asking which is positive review In which month the positive review exceeds the negative review by 25%? In this, let's see the table, and there is no part for even solving it. When you are directly looking to the table, you can find the answer. Let me tell you how to find easily without solving it. So these are the negative reviews and these are the positive reviews. Look at the table. In this table, which value in the negative reviews exceeds the positive? So here it is 50. It is exceeding to 70 in the positive. Here 80, 50. Again it is exceeding to 60. 80, it is less than. It is decreasing to 50, 70, 90, it is decreasing, 100, it is decreasing to 80. So, two values are exceeding than the negative reviews, which is 50 is exceeding to 70 and here 50 is exceeding to 60. Let's see what is the question. Number of positive review exceeds the number of negative review by 25%. They're asking, which is exceeding more than 25%. When you're seeing this two option, right, these two are only exceeding. So here 50, it is exceeding to 60, so it is like 10% exceeding. Here it is 50 to 70, it is 20% exceeding. So we can directly answer it is the month January, but you are not in the perfect thing. Because here they are asking 25%. Let's solve it with using this formula, and I will explain. So these after noting this, only 2 months are exceeding. Okay, so let's solve only for these 2 months. We are having a little confusion. Okay, so for clarifying this confusion, we are solving it. For January, it is. In A value is 70. 70 minus 50 by 50 into 100, you will get 40%. And for March, if you want, you can solve for each and every month and you can find the answer. This is a simple way to find the answer quickly. For March, the value is 60 minus 50 by 50 into 100. So you will get 20%.
So 40% is more than 25%. Number of percentage review exceeds the number of positive review exceeds the number of negative review by 25%. So 40% we are having in January, which is more than 25%. It is exceeding, right? 20% is less than 25%. We can't take this as an option. So 40% is the answer here. So January month is the positive review exceeds than the number of review by 25%. So answer is January. Moving to the third question. Maximum percentage increase in the number of negative review in any month compared to the previous month. So here they are asking the maximum percentage increase in the number of negative review in any month compared to the previous month. Okay, negative review in any month compared to the previous month. Maximum increase. So we have to find all the month values, all the month percentage values, and we will be comparing with the previous month, and which month is having the maximum percentage, and that month will be the answer. How to solve this question is, let's take they're asking from the question, they're asking from February to July only. Okay, they're asking us to find from February to July. So let's start with February. For finding percentage, maximum percentage in February, we are using the same formula, which will be initial previous month value. So 60 will be the answer. Without solving also, you can easily find using the table. So maximum percentage increase in the number of negative review in any month compared to the previous month, we are asking. Comparing to the previous month, January, February is greater. So comparing to this February, this is lesser. We are taking the greater value only. So comparing to the previous month, March 50, April is greater, 80. So comparing to 80, it is less than, we are not taking. So comparing to the May, it is 90, this is greater. Again comparing to 90, 10, 100 is greater. So four months we are having. What are all the months? February, April, June and July. These months are greater when compared to the previous month. You can only solve for these 4 months, which is A value is 80, B value is 50. Here A value is 80 and B value is 50. Here A value is 90, B value is 70. Here A value is 100, B value is 90. Substituting in this formula, you will directly get the answer. And moving to the without solving, you can find the answer from the question. Moving to the final question, is a very simple question. They're asking the difference between the number of positive reviews in June and the negative review in March. So they're asking the difference between the number of positive reviews in June and the negative reviews in March. So what is the positive review in June? It is 60. What is the negative review in March? March, the negative review is 50. So 60 minus 50, it is 10. The answer is 10. So that's it for this line graph question. Just have to clearly go through the question so you will get the answer option. I've said you the ways to solve easily without solving and seeing the question, and with solving and even complicated solving. I've set 3 type of solving method in this line graph question. So if there is any query, you can ask me in the comment. Like, share and subscribe for more videos. Thank you.